Hey everybody, this is Andrew with the We Are Rising podcast. Fortunately, I cannot be there live for our interview with Tatsuki Sawamoto. Sawamoto will be taking on Daichi Kitakata at Rizin 25. The 12-2 fighter who was originally from Wakayama took his time out to talk to us. But unfortunately, we had to it became a one-person interview with LJ doing the interview, but thanks to the power of editing, I shall be in the interview asking questions to Sawamoto-san. And we hope that this comes out great. That being said, let us get to our interview with Tatsuki Sawamoto, fighter from the Brave Gym. LJ, ready when you are.
Yep, sure thing. So the first question we asked him was, "What are your thoughts on your opponent?" But as usual, I did the usual. Thanks for having us on our show, etc. So here we go. Sawamoto 選手、お忙しい中ご出演していただき誠にありがとうございます。で今回Rizin 25二度目の参戦になりましたが、対戦相手のご印象についてはいかがでしょうか。
対戦相手の印象は、まあ、打撃、ボクシングが結構上手な方で、で、遠い距離から一気に詰めてきてパンチの連打。で、相手が嫌がってタックル入ったら、フロントチョークを決めに行くっていう印象です。
So he said, I get the impression that he's a striker.He's a very good boxer. He closes the distance and delivers strikes continuously. His opponents often, don't like his technique and end up going for a tackle. And at that point, he often then goes to finish them off with a front choke. So that was his thoughts on Kitakata. Andrew, yeah.
The next question we have for Sawamoto-san is that most people are aware of his background as a fighter, but we asked him to explain more how he got into fighting for those who may not be familiar with his career.
視聴者の方々は既に沢本選手 のバックグラウンドとか存じていると思うんですが、まあ、知らない方のために沢本選手 の, がなぜ格闘技を始めたきっかけなどについて教えていただけますか。
格闘技を始めたきっかけは僕の父親が小学2年生の僕をその格闘技のジムに連れてったのが始まりで、でそこからレスリングとキックボクシングを始めましたね。小学2年生の時に、7歳の時ですね。で、小学5年生の時にボクシングを始めて、で、次17歳かな。高校2年生の時に柔術を始めて、そうです。まあレスリング、ボクシング、キックボクシング、柔術を、まあ、幼い頃からやってました。はい。
So Samura-san here says, I started Kaktogi because my father, when I was in grade two, took me to a Kaktogi gym. From then, I started wrestling and kickboxing at around grade two. So this is when I was about 7 years old. And then around grade five, I also started boxing. Then maybe around when I was 17 years old, so that's around second year of senior high, I also started jiu-jitsu. So kickboxing, wrestling, boxing, and jiu-jitsu, I've been learning all of that since I was quite young.
The next, well, we had a ton of fan questions for him, being that he is quite a fan favorite fighter. And the first question came from our good friend Megaton, who asked, why was Zest or ZST the promotion he chose to develop in as opposed to Shooto, Deep, or one of the other main regional promotions in Japan?
こちらからファンの皆様からの質問に移りたいんですが、これは、
はい。
メガトンさん、アメリカのメガトンさんからの質問になります。沢本選手はMMA をデビューされて間もなくからZestで活躍されていると思うんですが、そして今現Zestフライ級チャンピオンですが、シュートやディープなどさまざまな団体がある中でZestを選んだ理由は何でしょうか？
まあ、僕がブレイブジムに入った時に、まあ、同じジムの選手がZestに出てて、で、まあ、シュートとかディープとかもちろんしてたんですけど、なんか最初自分もこのZestで戦っていって、で、チャンピオンになってから他の、まあ、ディープだったり他の団体に出たいなと思って、でそれで、まあ、経験積むためにZestに出始めた感じです。
はい。So here, Samura-san says, when I chose Brave, there were also other fighters competing in ZSD or ZEST. I knew there were other organizations like, you know, Deep and Shooto, but I thought, you know, I'd start off by trying to become a champion in ZEST and then sort of move on to other organizations. So I guess the main reason that he chose ZEST was because he wanted to build experience as an MMA fighter.
Very interesting. Very interesting. Wakari Mas. We had a second question from Megaton as well. And they asked, why does he, Sawamoto, think that his team, again, his team is the Brave Gym, coached by Little Hercules Miyata, Kazuki Miyata, who has been successful converting wrestlers and other grapplers into fighters?
では次の質問に移らせていただきます。これもメガトンさんからのご質問です。はい、総合格闘技に転向、そのレスリングから総合格闘技に転向する際、結構苦難される選手とか多いと思うんですが、まあ、その中、ブレイブジムは、その沢本選手を含め、数々のレスリングの出身の強いファイターが所属されている印象ですが、その育成が成功されている理由や強さの秘訣は何だと思いますか？
まあ、僕の場合はレスリングだけやってきたわけじゃなくて、他にボクシングとかキックボクシングもやってたんで、でそのブレイブを選んだ理由がまあ、ブレイブジムの代表の宮田和幸先生がレスリング出身っていうこともあって、まあ、レスラーを育てやすいみたいな、レスラーが総合するときに必要なテクニックとかいろいろ詳しいんで、まあ、それで他の、僕以外のレスリング出身者を、まあ、いろいろスカウトしたりとかして、まあ、レスリング選手が、総合 MMA を始めたときに、まあ、最初に、まあ、打撃とかいろいろ覚えることが多いんで、まあ、レスラー特有の体の使い方とか構えとかステップとかいろいろその宮田先生も経験してきて、でそれを上手に僕らに教えてもらってるんで、それがみんなうまく型にはまって、まあ、結果出してるのかなと思ってます。
質問に。So, for this question, Samura-san says, in my case, I wasn't only doing just wrestling, I was doing boxing and kickboxing as well. But the reason why I chose Brave was, I guess, because the head, Kazuyuki,Miyata sensei has a wrestling background. He scouted people, including myself, who have been learning wrestling. And when wrestlers, you know, transition to MMA, there is a lot of stuff that they need to, learn and focus on, such as striking. But because Miyata sensei has a wrestling background, he's able to teach us very well the ways to move our body, certain steps, etc., from the perspective of a former wrestler and his own experiences. And I think everyone's been able to learn that very well and as a result, deliver successful results.
Yes, and it definitely showed, especially in his Ryzen debut, where he won his fight by knockout. So...Miyata is doing great there, especially with Sawamoto-san. Our next question was another fan question from our good friend Luke. And he asked, with him, Sawamoto, and Makoto Shinryu's outstanding debut performances, does he think Ryzen are going to establish a flyweight 125-pound division in the future?
させていただきます。こちらはあのイギリス の, あのルークさんからの質問ご質問です。
はい、
沢本選手やあの新竜誠選手 の, あのライジンデビューであのフライ級が一気にあの 盛り上がったようにあの感じますが、まあ、沢本選手あのご自身はあのライジン の, そのフライ級 の, あ の, そのなんていうんですかね、その開拓についてこれあのどういうふうに思われていますか。
まあ、フライ級、まあ、今バンタム級がめちゃくちゃ、いろんな選手が集まってきて層が厚くなって、まあ、激戦区に なってるんですけど、まあ、ゆくゆくはフライ級も同じような感じにしたいなと思って、まあ、自分とか、まあ、他にもフライ級の選手が日本人結構多いんで、まあ、そういう人たちと一緒に、フライ級をもっといろんな選手集めて今のバンタム級とかライト級ぐらいあの盛り上がるようにしていきたいなと。で、その自分が先頭に立って来人のフライ級を引っ張っていきたいっていうのはありますね。はい。
So Samura-san said Bantamweight is definitely the most stacked division in Ryzen at the moment. But I really hope that will be the case also with the flyweight division going forward. There are many flyweight fighters other than myself in Japan, so I hope that we can together make the flyweight division as hyped as the bantamweight or lightweight division. And I intend to lead the flyweight division in Ryzen.
Great, great. That's always good to hear that someone's proud of the division they are, especially because...A lot of flyweights don't get a lot of the recognition, at least in places like UFC. And I don't even think Bellator has a 125-pound division, as far as I can recall. LJ, you did have a question that you asked yourself, wanted to ask Sawamoto-san. Would you like to ask it in English?
Yep, sure, that's right. So I asked him, do you have any intentions to do the bantamweight division in the future, despite, you know, him just talking about how he wants to lead the flyweight division. We understand that you previously fought Hishan Fujita in deep at under 62 kilos. So let's hear what he had to say to that question. Hi. So, じゃあ、私からの質問になるんですが、沢本選手は以前、ディープで、ハシャン・フヒト選手と、対戦されていますが、その時は多分、62キロ以下で、契約されていたと思うんですが、これから、今はフライ級を、引っ張っていくというふうにおっしゃっていましたが、将来、バンタム級に上げる予定などはありますか？
今のところはない。ですね、バンタム級に上げる予定はないですね。まあでもライジンのフライ級が、まあ、いまいち盛り上がらなくてなくなるってなればバンタム級に上げるかもしれないですね。まあでも現在今体が小さいので、まあ今のところはそのバンタム級に上げてっていうのは考えてないですね。でそのハシャン選手とバンタム級で戦ったんですけど、あれは、まあ、ライジンに出るために戦った感じで、
はい、
今はもうライジン出てるんで、はい、まあ、バンタム級でやる必要はないかなと。まあ、自分がすごい不利なんで。
はい、So Samura-san said, I have no plans to move up to bantamweight at the moment. But if the flyweight division...You know, it doesn't really become successful in Ryzen, I may consider it. At the moment, my body is quite small, so I don't really intend to go up a whole weight class, but I guess we'll see. Probably no plans at the moment. In terms of the match with Hishan-san, I fought him as a bantamweight in deep because I wanted to fight in Ryzen. And now that I've already been able to fight in Ryzen, I don't think there's really a need for me to go up to bantamweight because it's, you know, it just ends up being disadvantageous.
Mm-hmm. That's understandable. We will come back to his bantamweight career very soon. But before we get into that, we got to take the last question from Luke. And he asked, I saw in one of Sawamoto's YouTube videos that he has a PlayStation 3. And what video games are his favorite to play that he's playing?
またあのイギリスのあのルークさんからの質問に移らせていただきます。沢本選手のあの、はい、YouTube のチャンネルであのご自身があの今お住まいになられているあのプレハブのあのご紹介がありましたが、はい、その中であの、はいはい、あのプレイステーション3が置いてありましたが、沢本選手のお好きなゲームは何でしょうか。普段どんなゲームをされていますか。
あのプレイステーション3は本当にあのまあコロナウイルスで。まあ、外に出れないときに暇になって、まあ、そのプレイステーション3が安かったんで買ったんですけど、ほとんど1回しか使ってないんで、そのプレイステーション3を。なんで、たまに、他のゲームだとスイッチやったりとか、あと、プレイステーション4はやってますね。で、何、ソフトあとは、スマッシュブラザーズとか、スプラトゥーンとか、あと、PS4 だと、ウィニングイレブンとか、うん、あと、UFC もやってますね。はい。
So someone has said, I bought the PS3 because I was bored due to COVID and I couldn't go out. I've actually only played it once, but I do sometimes play other games.For example, like Switch, and for PS4, I play Smash Brothers, Splatoon, and Winning 11. I also do play the UFC game.
Just to clarify, he plays Splatoon and Smash on the Switch, you said, right?
I think so, yes. I okay. am not a game fanatic myself, those so are I'm not familiar with those games.
Because those two games are definitely not on the PS4. I can tell you that as a longtime Sony PlayStation fan. And, okay. As I will say, good choice in his system, PS3, and hopefully he'll adopt the PS5 when that comes out, I think, like in a week, I think, or maybe even already out in Japan, I don't know, but a good choice, a good system. Now, the next question I had for him, I always find it's very interesting because it's very rare to find this in Western fighters, very few. Johnny Case is one of the few Western fighters who has not lost once, but twice, but still had a successful MMA career. Sawamoto lost his first MMA match, and it's the only time he's ever been finished by rear naked choke. And my question to him was, can he talk about rebuilding himself after that fight and continue on to have a successful MMA career despite having his first pro fight be a loss?
ました。でこちらからあのアンドリューからの質問になるんですが、沢本選手はプロデビュー戦以外その KO やあの一本を取られたことはないですが、そのご自身のキャリアを振り返ってみて、そのあの時の試合があの今のその成績にどのようにつながったと思いますか。
一番最初デビュー戦の時にバックチョークで負けたんですけど、そのバックチョーク入られる前に、決められる前に、自分の肘を脱臼して、で、その、脱臼して、で、そのまま相手にバックポジション取られて、で、まあ、首に腕入れられてたんですけど、まあ、それよりまず自分の肘を、入れないと、脱臼したのを直さないと防御できないなと思って、で自分の肘を必死に直そうとしてるときに、首のバックチョーク決めに来てることを完全に忘れてて、でそのまま、そうですね、決められて、まあ、まあ今までの試合、最近はそうでもないですけど、まあ、ずっと勝ちにこだわってやってきて、で相手の、得意な、展開に、まあ、相手が寝技とか、グラップラーだったら、自分はタックル取られないで打撃で押して、で逆に、相手が打撃の選手だと自分がタックル入って寝かしてっていう、相手の得意な、展開を作らせないように今までずっと戦ってきたんで、まあそれが今の戦績につながってるかなと思ってます。はい。
打球はそれは大変ですね。最初のデビュー戦で。そしてこの前 の, あの あの中村選手と の, あの試合でも本当に素晴らしいあの KO 勝ちでしたね。あのその打撃の選手、向こうはその打撃の選手であるにもあの関わらず、そうこう向こう逆に向こう の, あの得意な技であの倒したというふうな印象ですね。
ああ、そうですね。一応あの、まあ、僕、まあ、バックボーンはレスリングが主にそのやってきたんで、バックボーンレスリングっていうふうにやってて、まあ、それで相手もすごい僕のタックルを警戒してるのが分かったんで、でそのタックルのフェイントに合わせて左のパンチオーバーフックたまたま入ったんですけど、まあ良かったですね。
So here Somoda-san said, yes, I lost my first pro fight via back choke. What happened though was that I had dislocated my elbow during the fight. I got into a bad position and I was trying to escape, but also fixing my dislocated elbow at the same time and was too focused that I didn't realize that my opponent had got me into the back choke position. When it comes to fights, I'm always focused on winning. I'll make sure that I bring the fight in a way that my opponent wouldn't like.So, for example, if I'm facing a grappler, I will try not to be taken down and strike them. On the other hand, if I'm facing a striker, I'll go tackle them and try and take it to the ground. I'm always trying to make sure that I don't create a scenario where they will be in the upper game. So I think those sort of perspectives has led to my current record. Mm. And then I ended up asking him another question.Leading from this one, I said, or more so a comment, I said, you know, he had an amazing sort of knockout in the recent Nakamura fight at Ryzen 23. And even though you were facing a striker, you ended up defeating him in sort of like, you know, vice striking, which is, you know, his Nakamura's expertise. And then he said, yes, my main backbone is wrestling. So I knew my opponent was scared of my takedown. So I, you know, pretended to go for the tackle and then,when he wasn't being observant, I went with the left overhook and then that was able to strike him down. So I was very glad.
That's the question. And we're going back to the 135, or actually, I think it was supposed to be at 125. So correct myself with that. But nonetheless, still 135, I guess, adjacent. He was supposed to have a fight with Kai Zakura, the current Ryzen, Bantamweight champion, in Rings, Outsiders promotion, a number of years ago. And we asked, do you think that since you two are on Ryzen, will your paths ever cross in a Ryzen ring?
では次 の, あの質問にあの移らせていただきます。過去にはそのあのあのリングスであのブレイブ vs あの G Outsider のあの対抗戦があのありましたが、あのそこであの朝倉海選手とあの対戦する予定がありましたが、ライジンの舞台でまた朝倉海選手と混じり合うことはあると思いますが、まあ、先ほどおっしゃった、まあ、フライ級であの活躍されるというふうにあのおっしゃっていたので、あのそちらについてあのどう思われますか？
まあ、さっき言ったみたいに、フライ級がなくなったら、あの僕がバンタム級に上げると思うんで、そうなればやる可能性はありますけど、まあ、フライ級がずっと続くようであれば、その朝倉選手がフライ級に落としてくるなら、あの、やることはあると思いますね。現状だと、まあ、フライ級もあるし、バンタム級も熱い、まああるんで、まあ、今の状態だとやることはないかなっていう感じですね。
はい。Yep, so he said, as I said previously, if there's no flyweight division, I'll go up to bantamweight. So there is a possibility. But as long as there's a flyweight division, unless Kai Asakura goes down to flyweight, there's probably, it's very unlikely that they will be facing each other. And for Kai, there's going to be considerable weight cutting to go down to flyweight. So the whole situation is pretty unlikely.
It'd be a good match nonetheless, I think. But, you know, he makes some good points.About himself and for Kai. LJ, you also had another question for him after, if you'd like to ask in English.
Yep, sure. So I asked him, is there anything he focuses on in particular when it comes to weight cutting before a fight? はい、では、 私からの質問になりますが、試合前の減量とか何かこだわりや心がけられていることありますか？
特にないですけど、僕の減量法だと、その計量を前日に一気にその水抜きして3キロとか、まあ、5キロとか落とすことはしないんで、そういうことはしないんで、まあ、一応2週間、計量から2週間前になると、もう食事制限始めて、その無駄なお菓子とか、まあ、油物だったりとか、そういう無駄というか、まあ、食べなくていい、体に悪い、体重が落ちづらくなるようなものは、もう、食べないようにして、低カロリー、高タンパクを意識して一応食べてますね。はい。
So he said, not really, but with my weight cutting technique, I don't do the thing where, you know, I dehydrate myself of 3 or 5 kilos before the match, unlike other fighters. About 2 weeks before weigh-in, I start being careful of my diet. I reduce oily foods or anything that's unhealthy or what will hinder my weight loss. I'll take that out of my diet. High protein and sort of food and low in calories is what I tend to have.
Oh, okay. That's interesting. That's interesting. You also had another question that you asked him after. A very common thing among, seems like Japanese fighters are starting to do. So I'll let you go ahead and ask the question.
Yep. So I asked him, you've recently started a YouTube channel. How do you plan on developing it going forward?では山本選手は今 YouTube の, チャンネルを開設されていますが、まあ、これからどのような企画とか どういうふうに展開されていく予定ですか？
まあ、今全然その YouTube に力を入れてないというか、もう本当に暇つぶしぐらいでやってるんで、企画とかその面白いことを考えてることもあんまりないんですけど、まあ、コメント、視聴者さんのコメントだったりとか、あと、なんか不意に思いついた企画とか、そういうのはちょこちょこ上げていこうかなと思ってて、なんかまあ、喧嘩自慢とスパーリングだったりとか、そういうのはやろうと思ってないです。
はい。So he said, I'm not really focused on my YouTube channel at the moment. It's more like a hobby for me.In terms of, you know, ideas and the kinds of videos I'm looking to post, I usually read the comments of my fans and subscribers. I always, you know, also think of some random projects that I might want to post. In terms well, of what I... Sorry.
Go ahead.
He was going to say, he also said, I don't plan to post any sparring videos with so-called, you know, delinquents on the street or that sort of thing, which I've personally seen is very, very popular with fighters. Yeah,
I think that's the I guess you could say that that's the new it's a prank bro social experiment trend of videos now, at least in Japan. And then my question was for him next was, and I mentioned this before about flyweights. As a flyweight fighter, do you feel flyweights get the recognition they deserve or are they not because of prejudice due to it being a small weight class?Being the one of the smallest weight classes for men.
Great, master. では、こちらアンドリューからの質問になりますが、沢本選手から見てフライ級に関しての その世間の声や意見についてどう思われていますか？例えばその、まあ、例えばボクシングとかだと軽量級はそのそこまでポピュラーじゃないというふうな、まあ、そういう意見もありますが、どう思いますか？それともその正当な認識や名声が確立されていると思いますか？
まあ、今はジックのレベルとかがすごい上がってきて、まあ、重量級の方がその KO とかあるかもしれないですけど、スピードとか全然ないんで、破壊力 だけで、その、ファンに、なんだろうな、見せてるなっていうのはあるんで。まあでも最近の軽量級の選手はもう本当にスピードもあって、スタミナもあって、テクニックもある選手が結構多いんで、
はい、
まあ、スピーディーな動きの中で一本勝ちとか KO 勝ちとかはもう全然重量級より軽量級の方があると思うんで、なんだろうな、まあ、軽量級の試合、まあ、フライ級とか、まあ、バンタム級とかそうですけど、すごい展開のある面白い試合が多いと思うんで、重量級は本当に今ボクシングしてるみたいな、ただパンチ力、まあ、体重も重たいんでパンチ力あるんで、それを先に当てたもん勝ちみたいな試合も、まあ、結構多いんで、うん、もっとスピードとかテクニックだったりとか、なんだろう、その展開、試合の中での展開とかを見ていただければ、まあ、絶対軽量級の方が面白いと思うんで、うん、そうですね、もっと、フライ級にファンがついてほしいですね。フライ級全体に。はい。
So he said, I think the flyweight division is really high level. He might see a high knockout rate in the heavier divisions, but they really lack speed. It's more about power in the heavier divisions, but fighters in the sort of lighter divisions not only have speed, but also stamina and technique these days. There's a lot of fighters like that. Whilst being speedy, they're also able to often, knock out or submit someone andYou might actually even see a higher percentage than the heavier divisions. I think fights in the lighter divisions, such as flyweight and bantamweight, are actually quite exciting the way the fights end up playing out. And heavier fights are, in a way, almost like boxing. You sometimes end up just focusing on who throws the hardest punch first. I think speed, technique, and the nature of the match itself is a lot more exciting when you look at fights in the lighter divisions. And I hope that there will be more fans surrounding the flyweight divisions and fans for fighters across overall.
Well, I think also I should have clarified, that it's mainly a Western or at least American idea that the flyweights are not exciting or that they can't draw. I mean, look at who the two most popular fighters right now in Japan, former flyweight, Kai Sakura, and also a flyweight, I think he still fights in boxing, kickboxing, Tenshin Asakawa. So, you got two of the most popular guys and they're not 145, 155. So,hopefully that can at least change in the West, this idea of this negative perception of flyweights. You had another question for him next, LJ.
Yep, that's right. So I asked him, what would you consider to be your most difficult fight overall?で、こちら、私からの質問になりますが、サモト選手のその今までの戦績を振り返ってみて、一番苦難した試合はどちらになりますか?
一番、あまり、追い込まれた試合とか、危なかった試合とか、あんまりないんですよね。今までなんか普通に、なんか本当にギリギリの試合をしたことがないんで、苦難はあんまり、ないですよ。でも強いて言えばハシャーン選手と試合したときに、1ラウンド目の終盤の方、終わりの方に、三角締めをちょっと決められそうになって、でその時にちょっと呼吸ができなくて、本当にギリギリ呼吸できてたんですけど、まあ、それでちょっとスタミナが奪われて、2ラウンド目に、失速したのが、まあ、一番の苦しい試合でしたね。 まあ、苦しかったですけど、まあ、試合内容としては圧倒してたかなと思うんで、うん、まあ、その試合ですね。
そうですね。あの時、あのチョークからの、あの見事にこう、あの、あの組からの、あの脱出したというふうな印象でした。私もあの試合を見て。
ありがとうございます。
So Samura-san said, I don't have many fights where I was under a lot of pressure or it was difficult, but, and I haven't really experienced a match where I was really at the edge. But if I had to choose one, probably the Hishan-Fajito match, because at the end of the first round, I almost got submitted by a triangle choke. That was the first time I couldn't breathe. I was really just breathing. That led me to feeling quite suffocated in the second round, and, you know, I lost a bit of stamina, but that was probably the hardest match. But in terms of the match as a whole, I still think that I dominated him. And then I also made the comment that if you actually look at the fight,on the video of the fight, you see Samura-san getting very impressively out of that triangle choke.
Very nice, very nice. It was so funny how he took a while to think of, what fight has been most difficult? I mean, he has 15 wins and only two losses, so you figure he'd pick one of the ones that he lost, but no, he picked one of the ones that he won. That's an interesting choice on his part. Regarding we had one last question for him, and we asked him to comment for his fans, and if he had any last words for anybody who was watching, who will be watching the interview.
最後に沢本選手からそのファンの皆様に向けて何かメッセージはありますか？あとそしてご自身 の SNS のご紹介、YouTube チャンネル、スポンサーの方へのメッセージなど何かありましたらお願いいたします。
まあ、そのファンの皆さんには次の試合、ライジン2025での試合もあと面白い試合を期待していただきたいなと思います。まあ、僕は本当にスピードもそうですけど、フィジカル、パワーにも自信があるんで、動きのある、迫力のある、面白い試合をしたいなと思ってます。で、まあ、YouTube も最近始めたんで、チャンネル登録していただきたいと思います。はい、以上です。
はい、ありがとうございます。選手へ、本日お忙しい中ご出演していただき、誠にありがとうございました。Ryzen 25 の試合、非常に楽しみにしておりますので、沢本選手のご健勝とご多幸をお祈りしております。
ありがとうございます。頑張ります。
ありがとうございました。Thank you guys. You can catch us on our next episode. So his comment to his fans, he said, I hope fans can look forward to my next match at Ryzen 25, which should be very exciting. I have confidence that my speed as well as my physical power will be able to dominate the match. I should be able to show some exciting and extravagant movements. I've also started my YouTube channel recently, so I'd be grateful if you could subscribe to my channel. And then at the end, I said, you know, thank you very much, Samura-san, for your time, and we look forward to your match at Ryzen 25. Just for those listeners who are listening, probably thinking, why am I, hosting the show at the end? If you just heard me say, you know, thanks for, and catch us at our next episode, that was because I was initially... interviewing and translating simultaneously, so I hope you can understand that. But yeah, Andrew, that was everything in the interview. Shall we I guess maybe we should introduce where all our listeners can follow Samura-san on Twitter and
yes.
Instagram and that sort of thing. I can do that if you'd like.
Yes, because I can't minimize apparently my Zoom thing.
No worries. So you can follow Tetsuki Samura-san on Twitter. That's at Tetsuki Samura-1996-1004. His Instagram is Tetsuki underscore brave. And you can also search him up on his YouTube channel, and we will post a link on our Twitter or our podcast page.
Yes, and you'll be able to catch him live fighting Daichi Kitakata at Ryzen 25. on November 21st. I will be on the Ryzen Live streaming network. I don't know the price, but we can presume that it's going to be around $50 probably. But I think Sawamoto has a lot of confidence going into this fight, and I think we're going to see him extend his win streak to 16-2, and we might have a future flyweight champion if that belt ever gets graded in Ryzen. If you want to catch us, you can catch us at We Are Ryzen Pod on Twitter. YouTube is We Are Ryzen Podcast. SoundCloud is We Are Ryzen Podcast. Also, check out the Discord, Ryzen FF Fans. If you want to follow me on my personal account, that's abenja1. We hope you enjoyed this interview and this unique presentation. Thank you all. Take care. Be safe. Be healthy. Take care.